this, Prabhupada writes elaborate purport to one verse in the first canto, second chapter. I'm going to close with this point. It's time now. Tat shraddhadhana munayo jnana vairagya yuktaya pashyanti atmani chatmanam bhaktya shruta grihitaya. Bhakti is based on Vedanta, Shruti, based on the Vedas. Bhakti is not some sentiment, merely a sentiment, emotion, emotional outpouring of some sentimental person. No, bhakti is based completely on Vedanta. And that bhakti based on Vedanta is what is explained in Bhakti Vedanta purports. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he had conversation with Sarvam Bhattacharya, when he had conversation with Prakashananda Saraswati, both were Mayavadis, thinking that Vedanta means Mayavada philosophy, Shankaracharya's explanation. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained, Shankaracharya's explanation is not the correct explanation of the Vedanta philosophy. The correct explanation is given by the Vaishnava Acharyas. Because they explain devotional service in terms of Vedanta. That is the Vaishnava Acharya's explanation of the Upanishads, of the Vedas, of the Puranas, of the Itihasas, of all the Vedic literature. The Vaishnava Acharyas give the perfect explanation. So therefore, devotional service has to be executed on the basis of the understanding of Vedanta philosophy. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he quotes Kali Santarana Upanishad in support of chanting Hare Krishna. Brihannaradiya Purana says this Hare Krishna mantra has to be chanted. But some people will say, oh, that Purana is all Smriti. Shruti is what we follow. For that Shruti reference, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving Kali Santarana Upanishad. So, our Krishna Consciousness movement, bhakti, is established on the basis of Vedanta, the original Vedas. That's why Prabhupada got the title Bhakti Vedanta. Because he is establishing bhakti on the basis of Vedanta philosophy.